Well, thank you all once again so much for being here. And Debbie will lead us into a spirit of worship as we listen to the prelude.
Thank you, Debbie. That's one of my favorites, Mary's little boy child. Anyway, good evening and Merry Christmas. We welcome you here at the Russellville Community Church to our annual Christmas Eve service. If you are a first-time visitor, we want you to feel like our guest of honor. We are so pleased that all of you are here, and would you please stand and join with me as we do the call to worship. Christ came into the world that had problems, much like the ones with which we grapple today.
To those without the joy of living, Jesus said, I have come that they may have life, and that they may have it more abundantly.
To those who bore the chafing burden of the guilt of sin, he said, be of good cheer, your sins are forgiven you.
To the rebels, he said,
Christmas means that Emmanuel has come, that God is with us. Our opening hymn is number 281, and we'll be singing verses 1 and 3.
Thank you.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You'll find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what they had been told about the child. And all who heard were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned and glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Imagine the scene in Bethlehem. It was the night of nights, and yet it had begun just like any other night had before it. In Bethlehem's houses, mothers lay their children down to sleep. In the courtyards of the inns, the camels lay down for rest. In the fields, the shepherd lay down with the shepherds. The sheep lay down with the shepherds near their fires. And in the heavens above appeared the same stars that had shined throughout all the ages, ever since God had made the stars to rule by night. Here in the dark cave, as a flickering torch cast high shadows of long-horned oxen on the rough-hewn logs, there is no sound but the munching of hay by the cattle. In the mist lies the young mother, forgetting for the moment her discomfort, for in her arms lies the babe, her baby boy.
Who would dream that in a manger in a remote Bethlehem, a baby would be born to a young woman and her betrothed, and that baby would be the Savior of the world, teaching people to know and love God, forgiving sin, healing the sick and broken. Father God, thank you for this gift. We may truly receive him. Amen.
Kingdom. establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever.
Come up from the stump of Jesse, from his roots a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of power, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord, and he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes, or decide by what he hears with his ears, but with righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice, he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips, he will slay the wicked. Righteousness will be his belt, and faithfulness the sash around his waist. The wolf will live with the lamb, the leopard will lie down with the goat, the calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear, their young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the hole of the cobra, and the young child will put his hand in the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
Isaiah was foretold it, the rose I have in mine. With Mary we behold it, the virgin mother kind, to show God's love aright. She bore to man a Savior, when half spent was the night.
Matthew 1:18-25. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus.
Stars are brightly shining, it is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. Thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel's voice.
And from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up to the town of Nazareth in Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Will you please stand and turn to page 249 and join with us in singing, O Come, All You Faithful.
Thank you. Thank you. In the book of Luke, chapter 3, verses 4 through 6. As it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, the voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill made low. The crooked roads shall become straight, and the rough ways smooth. And all people will see God's salvation.
John 3:16-17. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him.
If you would like to turn to page 270 and join us on the last verse of Joy to the World, we would love to have you all join us. Prepare our hearts to go to the Lord in prayer. Let's sing the prayer hymn. We're going to sing 251, verses 1 and 4. And loving God, we're so grateful for this time to come to worship you. We're just so grateful that you sent Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. You came, God incarnate, to be here with us, to teach us, to learn what it was like to be a human being. Lord, we're just so grateful that you love us, that you come to save us, and that you come to just have fellowship with us. How amazing it is that you want to have a relationship with us. Lord, we're just grateful once again for all of the many blessings you've given to us. Lord, for every need represented in these pews tonight, whether it's for health or whether it's for finances or whether it's a child who's on their way to be born into this world. We lift up these folks to you this evening and pray, Lord, that you meet every need and that you comfort every heart that's here in this place tonight. We ask, Lord, that you would hear us as together we pray the prayer Jesus taught his disciples, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Would you turn with me to Matthew's Gospel, chapter 1, verses 18 to 25? I promise this is going to be brief. I know our little people are getting tired. So turn with me, Matthew chapter 1. We're going to read this part again. You've heard it already tonight, but we're going to read it again. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. And this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. Thanks be to God for the reading of this word tonight. Maybe you have a hard time imagining and understanding how God could decide to become a human being. I had a friend, one of my very favorite stories to tell at Christmas was about a friend who was a farmer, and he and his wife had a wonderful life together, but he did not want to go to church. And he did not want anything to do with that part of his wife's life. And she would always ask, honey, you want to go to church with me today? No, you go ahead on. I'll stay here and read the paper. Well, this particular Christmas Eve was no different. She got ready to go to the Christmas Eve service and said, honey, you want to go to church? He said, no, I'll be all right just sitting here in front of the fire reading my paper. And so it was beginning to snow, and he said, do you want me to take you? And she said, no, I'll be all right. You can come get me if it gets real bad. So she took off, and he went, sure enough, sat down in front of the fire to read his paper. And all of a sudden, he heard this at the window. He thought, what in the world? So he got up, and he went over to look out the window. And there was this bird. And it had flown into the window, been blown. There was a storm just really getting it out there. Snow blowing everywhere, wind everywhere. And this bird hit this window. And so it was stunned. He thought, well, I'll go and I'll put it under a tree or something, give it some shelter. So he gets outside and he goes around to get this bird. And it was so frightened of him, it just kept hopping away from him. And then he saw that there were more birds. A whole flock of them had been blown down. Before they could get to shelter, a storm had come on so suddenly, and they were all just terrified of him. And he kept thinking, well, how am I going to get them to shelter? And so he opened up the barn door, the man door, and he thought they'll go inside. And they just stood there in the snow and the wind. And he said, I'll just herd them in. Well, have you ever herded a chicken? Yeah, birds are the same thing. And he's trying to herd these, shoo these birds into the barn. They didn't want to go. And he thought, well, I'll feed them. If I feed them, they will go in the barn. So he opened up the bigger door of the barn. You know how barns are. They've got a man door and they've got an implement door. So he opens up the implement door and he finds his wife's bird seed because she liked to feed the birds. And she, and if you're like our house, we don't feed the birds. We feed hogs because they eat so much all winter long. You're always at the store buying bird seed. Well, so he scatters the bird seed along the path going to the big door of the barn. They will certainly go in, he thought. Oh, no. They just were terrified, scattered every time he tried anything. They were scattered, and he was getting more and more frustrated with these birds. And then finally he said, if I could just become a bird, then I could show them the way to the barn. And in that moment, it clicked in his head how God became one of us to show us the way, to show us what love is, to show us how to live the life that he has for us. And he thought, if I hurry up, I can get to church. And so he left the birds. They weren't going to follow him anyway. And his wife, who was sitting in the choir loft, looked up just in time to see her sweet husband walk through the door. And that was the best gift she ever got at Christmas time, was seeing her husband come through the door. And so, of course, the birds found their own way. They're birds. They knew what to do. They've survived worse, probably. And so when they got home, they were all sheltered under a big pine tree. But I love that story, because that story teaches us and tells us that God pitched his tent. The people of Israel lived in tents. They were nomadic people. And God went before them, went above them. And then God came to become one of them, literally pitched his tent to live among us. And so God understands everything that you and I are going to go through. God understands when we hurt. God understands grief. God understands all of the things that are part of the human condition because he chose to become one of us. So if you're struggling, if there are concerns that you have in your heart, know that God loves you. God wants a relationship with you. God wants a relationship with me. And he came here to prove it. Let's pray. Gracious and loving God, thank you for becoming one of us so that you could understand us and we could understand you. Help us to open our hearts to you anew this season. Help us to welcome Christ into our world, into our church, into our heart. For it's in his name we pray. Amen. Each one of us is welcome to gather around the Lord's table. It's such a blessing to share in the Lord's Supper together as a family of faith. And on this night in particular, it's so special to remember that Jesus Christ came to love us and to share himself with us and to give his life as a ransom for those of us who will come to know him and his grace. And all are welcome to partake of this communion meal. Let's prepare our hearts for communion by singing hymn number 271, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore You.
Thank you.
invite all of you to come. You're welcome to come out the center aisle and return by the side aisles. And on the night when Jesus was betrayed, he met in the upper room with his disciples. After supper, he took bread, he blessed it, and he broke it, and he gave it to them. And he said, "Take and eat, all of you. This is my body given for you."
Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to come to see you and enjoy the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. Please watch over, guide us, and lead us in our direction. We ask this in your name. Amen.
And in like manner, Jesus took the cup after supper, and he blessed it, and he shared it with them and said, "Take and drink, all of you. This is the blood of the new covenant, poured out for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me."
Died upon the cross for our sins. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
take a prayer together.
If they haven't done it yet. As often as we eat the bread and drink the cup, we proclaim the Lord's death till he comes again. Let us close in prayer. Gracious God, as we get ready to depart from this place, we pray that you'd bless each one who is here tonight. Bless our travels and help us, Lord, to celebrate with an open heart all that you've given to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We go from this place tonight. Let's carry the light of Christ into the world with us. Wherever we go, be a light to the world for Jesus. Amen. Go in peace. Love and serve the Lord.